What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 16 of the Ultimate Let's Play Pokemon Training Card Game. We are getting ready to take on the Grand Masters. Before I do, though, I want to make a quick pit stop at the Fighting Club. I just need to continue this training sequence with this guy. He's looking for Weezing. But, I don't have Weezing, so I cannot do anything with that yet. And I think what I'm going to do here, though, is I want to make a couple of changes to my deck. I know that I'm going to be dealing with someone who can bring a lot of energy onto the table, so I'm going to max out my energy removals and super energy removals in my deck. In exchange for, like, taking out maybe a plus power, which I usually don't have a need for. Let's have both these at the ready here. Someone I could maybe part with here. Now I'm going to take out the Vaporeons and the Eevees. So that means I got room for one more in here. Could bring Snorlax, basically as a tank, so I think that's what I'll do here. And I've got 20 water energy and all four of my double colorless, which is the max that the game is going to let me allow to have. So, let's head to the Pokemon Dome, and let's get started on the Grandmasters. Those in search of the legendary Pokemon cards, defeat the Master of the Eight Clubs and attain the Eight Medals. I've done that. Once obtained, defeat the Grandmasters here at Pokemon Dome, then you shall inherit the legendary Pokemon cards. Let's go in. Only those who have won all eight Master Medals may enter the Grand Hall. You've won all eight Master Medals. Enter the Grand Hall. Thank you. Alright. Possessor of all eight Master Medals, enter the dueling stage. However, you will be unable to turn back. Alright, so basically this is like the Elite Four of the original Pokemon games. I won't be able to exit once I start. However, in between each duel, I will be allowed to fine-tune my deck as I need to. So, there's no getting out at this rate. In that case, enter the dueling stage. Welcome to Pokemon Dome. I am Rod, leader of the Grandmasters, and this is Grandmaster Courtney, the Fire Queen. Grandmaster of Lightning, Thunder Steve. Grandmaster of Ice, Gentlemanly Jack. We are the four Grandmasters who guard the legendary Pokemon cards. If you can defeat all of us, then you will have earned the right to inherit the legendary Pokemon cards. T.U.G, please take your place at the table. Alright. Didn't clear my throat there. Your first opponent shall be Courtney. I, Courtney the Fire Queen, shall be your first opponent. We shall see if you can take the heat. A six prizes match. Let's go to it. The Legendary Moltres deck of Grandmaster Courtney. And you'll see why I put a bunch of energy removals in my deck. Now this is actually a good start with Tauros, and I'll have Squirtle at the ready as well. She's going to start with two Pokemon on her bench. Okay, I will go first. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and put that double colorless on Tauros, and I can at least get a quick attack in for Stomp. Get some bonus damage while I'm at it. Here comes Smokescreen. It means we're going to have to flip a coin to be able to attack next turn. And I really don't want to burn my Reserve card right now, so I'll start building up Squirtle. I'll try stomping again. Unfortunately, I cannot get the attack off. Alright, going for Smokescreen again. Alright. I'm gonna go ahead and burn this energy removal on the Magmar here. Couldn't get the attack off again. Pokemon Trainer. Train one of the basic Pokemon or evolution cards in your hand for one of the basic Pokemon or evolution cards from your deck. Throwing Growlithe back and bringing in, obviously, the legendary Moltres, which she's gonna put on her bench and activate its special ability, Fire Giver. When you put Moltres into play during your turn, not during setup, put from 1 to 4 chosen at random fire energy cards from your deck into your hand, shuffle your deck afterwards. So here comes the Fire Giver. So she's putting 1. She's putting 2. She's putting 3. She put 3 fire energies into her hand, just like that. Going for Smokescreen again. I don't know why I wasted that, energy removal. Seems to have done me no good here. I'm gonna heal myself real quick. I would love to get one of my war turtles ready here. I don't want to give up that Blastoise. Again, unsuccessful. Again, it's gonna be the coin flips that kill me here. So I'm getting plenty of my water energy. I'll go ahead and give one to Tauros. Because then he can use Rampage. Okay. In case I want to use Rampage. Alright, go ahead and stomp. Again, that's 4 in a row now that I think I've missed. And another legendary Moltres going onto the bench. Let's put in another 2. 3. 3 more fire energy into her hand. And those Moltres are getting ready for their dive bomb attack, I think it's called. Okay. I really do not want to give up, my Blastoise. Alright, I don't need to put in any more energy, so I'm gonna try Rampage. Okay, got the attack off there, and I avoid confusion. I'll take down that Magmar, get my first prize. Yes, that is what I needed. Okay, one more Moltres is coming out. Now, I know it's got no attack. And wouldn't you know it, I've had another war twirl waiting in the wings. Alright. Well, I'll go ahead and rampage again. Avoid confusion. I'm probably gonna get dive bomb here, though. Yep, there it comes. But the dive bomb missed. Okay, Kangaskhan on the bench. Water energy to Kangaskhan. Evolve Wartortle to Blastoise. I'll go ahead and put that extra water energy. I can only attach. Oh, wait a minute. As often as I like during my turn before attack. It has to be a water Pokemon. It won't work on Kangaskhan. Okay. Fair enough, so I'll give it to Blastoise. Alright, Rampage. Okay, I am confused now, though. But I took down one of the Moltres, which is fine. And I gotta switch now. Okay. Energy retrieval, huh? Don't have any discards here. You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and switch. And now I'm gonna play Professor Oak. I can discard those other cards there. Now, let me see what I can do with Blastoise here. So, Hydro Pump does 40 damage plus 10 more damage for each extra energy attached to Blastoise. So, I can't... So, 5 is the maximum I can have on this guy. So, fair enough. I'll hit him with Hydro Pump. Okay, one more will put it away, and I don't think it's going to have enough time to get another dive bomb going. It's going to be sent up the Vulpix instead, which is fine by me. Okay, let's get a Magikarp. And you know what? Go ahead and burn the rest of these energy searches. Because maybe I'll get Gyarados to come out soon. So I'll beef up Magikarp while I can. Yeah, the reason why I was able to add one water energy on Kangaskhan is because I did not use my one allotment. So I can use that basically counted as the one energy card I was allowed to play. The ones we put on Magikarp were the extras. I'm gonna go and heal Tauros up a bit. Hydro Pump again, this will knock out Moltres. And now Bill card, okay, maybe I can find my Gyarados in there. Oh, he's got another Moltres, a different Moltres. But not gonna attack. Full heal, not gonna need. Let's see what Bill can get me here. Another Bill, okay. Jigglypuff and a gust of wind. You know what? I'm gonna put that Growlithe in. And I'll take it out with a Hydro Pump. Another gust of wind, huh? Attack, huh? Alright, well, energy removal on the Moltres. A gust of wind. Bring in that Vulpix. Hydro Pump you. Alright, well, there's Wigglytuff. Now I gotta take on the Moltres. What does super energy removal do again? Oh, okay. I'll lose the water energy on Tauros. I'll get rid of both the fire energy on Moltres, so you are completely defenseless. I have nothing else to play, so I'll just play Hydro Pump again. I think I've got her dead to rights here. Do even need a Gyarados? Blastoise just ran the table here. And it's a shutout victory over Courtney. I lose. But that's no surprise seeing how you've come this far. Your next opponent is waiting for you. Very good, T.U.G. Your second opponent is Steve. I, Thunder Steve, am your next opponent. Hey, do you want the legendary Pokemon cards? Then you must defeat me first. Is your deck ready, T.U.G? Yes, let's prepare for the duel. Now, I want to have a quick look at my notes to see what Steve will bring to the table here. Okay, so basically he has the Pokemon Power Peel of Thunder. So it's shooter type. Alright. So I definitely want to use some fighters here. So let's have a look at what I have. Alright. So we're wiping the slate clean. Blastoise, you did your job, and you can hit the showers. They even need my Articuno. Okay. So So I'm going to be going up against electric types. I'm going to keep my heavy hitters in. Let's switch out my water energy. I think I'm going to use mostly fighting here. I think I'm going to throw in a few psychics as well. Well, let me see here. Do I want to stick with fighting? Maybe I will. I want to use the ground types to have the resistance, though. So Dugtree would be good. Should do Gravel or Golem would be good. Again, I don't want to rely on that Stone Barrage. Cubone Marowak could come in handy. Okay. It's weird, I have more Rhydons than Rhyhorns. I'll throw in. I've got to have my Wigglytuff. Okay. Take out one energy removal and one super energy removal. You know, maybe I'll go ahead and throw in a Hitmonchan as well. So I want guys that can take a punch here that don't necessarily have to do a lot in terms of evolution. I suppose that's going to be the best I can do there. I definitely don't want to bring in flyers against an electric type. And I have my four double colorless in there as well. Alright. So honestly, I think my deck is going to be ready here. But I am going to call it quits here. And next episode, we will go ahead and take on Steve and the legendary Zapdos deck. So until then, this is T.U.G. saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.